Good morning po sa bawat isa. We would like to say good morning to everybody. Nanggit ko po na ang ating topic ngayon ay walang iba ang salitang, okay? How to keep our vision and purpose alive, okay? Make your vision and purpose come alive. Kasi po, binanggit ko po itong salita na to kasi sa totoo lang po, when we face crisis and adversity, we often lose our vision. That's the reality. When problem comes in like a flood, we stop, okay? And then when we stop, we hang on and then realize we can't make it, deceptions will come in, then suddenly the vision stop and it's no longer working, and then we're just waiting, and then you find out after 45 days, your ministry is not moving at all. So I'm here to help you and find a way so that we ourselves realize that our vision can come alive in the middle of this crisis. Okay? So I encourage you, keep on writing your vision and your purpose. And today we will find ways to keep this vision alive. Tandaan niyo po yan. This meeting, the number one goal and my objective is how to help you to keep them alive, to keep your vision alive. Okay? Because if we don't know how to keep our vision alive, it will fade away. Okay? You have to go and talk to your primary 12 and your cell leaders about the vision and the purpose open. You have to communicate, okay? And you have to intentionally envision the future together with your team. And we have to create tangible reminders and pictures for the future. That's the thing that we need to do right now. So the objective is to how to make your vision and your purpose come alive. So let me start from reading a scripture, okay? In the book of Ephesians chapter 5, verse 15 to 17, this is why it is said, "Wake up, sleeper, rise from the dead, and Christ will shine on you." You see this verse? You wake up first because you are sleeping. And then from after you wake up, you rise up from the dead. It means rise up from things that never works. You have to rise up. And Christ will shine upon you. Now you notice that Christ will shine upon you only if you wake up and you rise up. Okay? So our goal is to make our vision come alive. So if you want to come alive, this is the things that you need to do. You wake up. Okay, from your slumber. You wake up from your sleeping mode. It means when you're sleeping, you are unaware to what's happening in your environment. When you are sleeping, you are not moving. Okay? You are no longer on the movement mode. Okay? And I've seen this to many churches now. No, that's why it's a privilege to share this idea with you that we should never be paralyzed, immobilized by this pandemic problem. We need to wake up. We need to stand up and rise up. Then God or Christ can shine upon you, upon me. So the key here is opening your eyes and stand, okay? When you stand and rise, it means you are ready to move again. When God said, "Wake up, sleeper, rise from the dead," you come alive. You need to come alive. You know, we can use this pandemic problem as our reason not to be alive. But no, it's wrong. We need to wake up and rise up and come alive. Because God, Christ Himself, can rise up or can shine upon us. In verse 15, why? Because be careful then how you live. You see? You need to be careful how you live. Not as unwise, but as wise. Can you still live us wise in the middle of this crisis, in the middle of this COVID-19 situation, or we are unwise. Okay? He said, making the most of every opportunity. Listen to this. There is an opportunity waiting for us. While we are sleeping, opportunity is there. Okay? While in the middle of rising up, the opportunity is there. When Christ shine upon you, opportunity is there. If you are unwise, the opportunity is there. If you are wise, the opportunity is there. That's why God said, be careful. Then how you live, not as unwise, but as wise. Making the most of every opportunity because the days are evil. Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand what the Lord's will. So, I'm here this morning trying to be used by God, that may God help us. No, I will be so sad to see pastors who are doing the G12 vision. They can't make it. They are suffering. They stop. You know, they were paralyzed and immobilized again during this pandemic problem. So this morning, let us invite the Holy Spirit to come with us together, and let us welcome this word. That I pray that every one of you can hear the voice of the Spirit waking us up. Let's come alive again, okay? And rise up. Let's come alive. Because when we are alive again, we can move. There will be movement in our life. The crisis, the challenges that we face right now, immobilize many churches today. Huh? But no, let's come alive again. Let's go back to our movement. Okay, let's go back to our visions. So this morning, let's invite the Holy Spirit to come with us as we pray. Father, I praise you and I thank you because you said in your word that if anyone lack wisdom, ask. So we ask, Lord, that during the pandemic problem or the COVID problem in our midst, Lord, we pray that let not this challenge and crisis immobilize us and paralyze us, Lord. Father God, this spirit, Lord, will make us sleep, Lord. But your spirit will awaken us, Lord. So Holy Spirit, our governor, help us to wake up and rise up, Lord, so that Jesus can shine upon us, so that we could live a wise living, Lord. And I declare, Lord, because these are the days of evil, Lord, I pray that every one of us would understand what the Lord's will is. Holy Spirit, guide us, anoint us together, and let your people come alive again, Lord. Let the churches of Jesus come alive again out of this crisis in our midst. Thank you, and I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Now, our goal right now is to come alive again. Okay? Is it possible that in the middle of, you know, it's not a joke to be in the middle of crisis. I've seen churches has been shut down. No? Because the pastor cannot, you know, go to the new normal, you know, cannot recreate themselves. The vision dies. Or the vision slows down. Okay? So Satan is using this attack against us to immobilize the church, to paralyze the pastor, okay? To make the cells irrelevant on these pandemic conditions. But today I come in the name of the Lord. Rise up. Rise up. Stand. Wake up immediately so that Christ can shine upon us. I believe this morning, this is the will of God for us to be together, to encourage one another. Okay? I pray that this morning, you realize that it's not good to be immobilized. It's bad to be paralyzed. It's not good to become useless pastor, useless leaders or cell leaders. you are commanded by God to be fruitful in whatever conditions of the day. Remember this, the kingdom of God and His people, His citizen, can be, you know, can be a great influence in the middle of crisis. That's why I'm here this morning to encourage everybody, come alive again. Let your vision come alive. Let your purpose come alive. Let your dream come alive again. So as a pastor with team of leaders, primary 12, as a pastor with cells in my church, so I need to do something so that my church will come alive in our visions. Your vision must come alive. Your purpose and God's plan for your church must come alive again. Okay? When I said alive, it create movement again. It create movement. You know, because of the crisis, we some kind of slowing down. Okay? We cannot do what we used to do, the good old days. But I just recreated myself. I just repositioned myself. You know, I just repackaged myself and my ministry. And now I was able to create a new atmosphere, a new environment again in my life and my ministry. And now I come alive again. I come alive. I'm back to God's purpose. I'm back to God's vision for me and for my ministry. I'm back. I come alive. And that is my prayer right now. Everyone, every pastors, I want you to come alive. I want you to be back again. Okay, I want you to be back again in our strategy, in our vision. Back to soul winning, back to consolidation, back to disciple making, and back to sending leaders, and back to transforming our nations. Let's go back to our training so that our people would grow and mature. And let's go back so that when our people are growing and maturing, they are excited to serve the Lord. They are excited to help people find their way back to God. And our leaders are back again to help somebody to start up their new life. We need to come alive again. This is the challenge of the hour. We cannot be, you know, what we call the mediocre. Okay? We cannot afford to have that. And to be in our life, we have to be passionate again. We need to become aggressive again. We have to be intentional again. Why? Because it's good to come alive again. That's why Jesus is resurrected. He come alive again. He come to life. You know, He is alive again. Hallelujah. And right now, I have to come alive because there are thousands of people literally is hoping and, you know, relying on us as a leaders. Okay? I cannot be lousy because people are expecting and relying on us. You know? That's why I really got this title coming from the Holy Spirit, that this is the time to make our vision alive again. Now, what should we do so that our vision can come alive again? Okay? Now, listen very carefully. It's not about you. If you want your church to come alive from the vision, it's not about you. I realize that it's about me, my team of 12, my 144, and my cell leaders. This is the key. If you want to come alive, think about the team, not just you. You know, when you come alive as a pastor, still you cannot make it. Why? Because you don't have a team that are mobilized again for this movement. Imagine the pastor is alive and everyone is dead. How can you accomplish great things? When I said we come alive, together we come alive. The whole church. So my goal this morning is that I want to meet you through this. I visit your church. I visit your houses right now to bring the message of good news that we as a church can come alive out of this crisis. You and I, you and your team, all your cell leaders should be together as a team and let the Holy Spirit bring life to you again so that you could come alive and you can create another movement and the atmosphere will be changed again. And then we could effectively win souls and make disciples. Again, we're back on track. We are transforming lives. We are transforming families. We are transforming our cities and we are transforming our nation and the rest of the world. We need to come alive. The empire should strike back. The kingdom of God is striking back. So I'd like to encourage you, by the help of the Holy Spirit, you will come alive in Jesus' name. You will come alive. Pastors, you will come alive again. Leaders, primary 12, you will live again. You will come alive again. And you will become fruitful again and multiplying, because that's the will and the intent of God for us. Remember, God has no wrong intention why we go through this crisis. I believe that God allowed this crisis to happen so that all the people, okay, God want to get their attention. Now money is no longer functioning well for them. No? You know, when you're in the middle of, you know, it's suddenly the poor and the rich have the same leverage now. Why? You realize that your master, your money, cannot do anything right now. It becomes useless. That's why today is God getting your attention. Pastors and leaders, is God getting your attention? Is your eyes now, it's not on you. You don't just see your own needs, but you see the needs of other people. Every one of us, it's our responsibility not to look at our own condition, but look at every opportunity out there. The people are desperate. They were all looking for God, and they are now ready. It was prepared by our God for us, church. That's why I personally believe that every church can grow, every cells can complete their 12, every leader of leaders can complete their 144 during this pandemic situation. Because this is our time. This is our season. For everybody, okay, tawag ko dito, I call this the microscope mentality, or you are telescope mentality. What is telescope mentality? Telescope mentality is you see the long look. You see the picture far. That's telescope. But microscopic, you see and magnify things. Okay? So the microscopic people are the one that are just looking at the present situation. They magnify the problem. You know, they complain. They whine. Oh, they say negative things. Their mind is negative. Their attitude is negative. Those are microscopic people. But every good pastor is a telescopic, because we don't see not just what's happening in us, but we see further than this. I want to become a telescopic pastor. But I use my microscope, okay, to recreate myself, to understand the atmosphere, to understand the environment, to understand what's going on, to understand what should I do at this present condition in the middle of crisis. So, I will never stay on my microscope. Once in a while, I look at my telescope. Where? My destination. The place I should be. This is temporary. I will repeat. Your condition, your microscope right now, your picture on that microscope is temporary. This crisis is temporary. The situation is temporary. But the plan of God, your gift, your assignment is permanent. The promise of God is permanent. That's why we never stay looking at our microscope. We should look at our telescope. And then when you look at, you see the picture of your tomorrow, you no longer look at the present, you no longer at the past, but you are looking beyond what is happening right now, because I believe the future is more exciting than our present conditions. In fact, the future will give you more excitement to become innovative, to recreate yourself, okay? To be positive, you know, in your outlook, because I'm excited about my future. I know that all this crisis is just temporary. This is not my permanent condition. I know that, because God will never be defeated. God will never lose. God will, His purpose and His will happen. Hallelujah. And the purpose of God is this. The earth will be influenced by heaven. The earth will be covered by its culture, with its citizens, with values and standards and principles in their life. at the end of the day, God's purpose will prevail. So don't worry, relax. Chill lang tayo, mga kapatid. Can, Daddy, can I have water, please? Naniniwala po, I always believe that every one of us can overcome this crisis. So, my brother and sister, make sure that everyone is on the bus. Okay? If you're a pastor, this is about the team now. You cannot prevail and succeed and create a movement in your church. You cannot change the environment unless the team is intact. And this is our goal. My heart and my desire is to make you, pastor, your primary 12, and all your cell leaders should be intact, should be one. You should become a team. That's why I like that word, no? Make sure that everyone is on the bus. Ang ibig kong sabihin, tiyakin yung kasama nyo, yung mga leaders nyo. Be sure that all your leaders is on you and with you. Okay? Because we have to be ready. We are about to move forward powerfully to our God-given destination. Everyone must be on the bus. Everyone should go with me. I have to tell my team, my primary 12, we have to be one. We have to be together in this. We have to move forward powerfully for our destined success. Okay? We have shared vision and a greater purpose as a team. Do not forget that. Okay? In fact, this day, every pastor should pause along the way. Why? And look back and make sure that everyone is in the bus. What if 2 or 5 of your primary 12 is not on the bus? Meaning to say, he's not with you. He's not journeying with you. He is not following you. He is disconnected to you. You cannot afford. No one is left behind. Not one pastor is left behind. Not one leader should be left behind. Everyone must be on the bus. Sabihin mo sa tropa mo, everybody must be on the bus. Okay? If a team, a church, isn't on the bus together, then where are these people? Okay? If they are not moving powerfully in the same direction with you, man, I promise you, malabo yun. Now, another thing, when you ask people to be with you, this is our plan, this is our strategy, this is now the new normal. Yes, the people begin to jump into the bus. But the question, another question is everyone is still in the bus? Are they still excited about the journey of our vision and God's plan for our church and our family and our life? Think about it. You have to ask, you have to pause for a while, pastor, and begin to analyze, is everybody in? Is everybody is already in the bus? Or there are people already jumped into the bus, but are they still in the bus? Are they still excited? So not just be in the bus, but they must be all excited. Again, I ask this, pastor, are you still in the vision? Huh? Are you still in the strategy of the vision? Are you still excited about how to grow your church? Are you still in the kingdom of God? Are you still a citizen of the kingdom? Hallelujah. When everyone who influences the team to get on the bus, we have to be together on this. Okay? We have shared vision. We have a greater purpose, and the team must become coherent. Okay? I believe when we are one with same vision, with same purpose, it becomes an unstoppable force of momentum and positive energy is coming upon your team. I'm literally, you know, I'm excited about my team because I know I cannot make it without my team. So all my primary 12, if you are listening right now, you're either on the bus or outside of the bus. When I said in the bus, it means we have shared vision together. We have shared purpose together. And we are one together, excited, creating a movement in our church so that everybody can jump in and join the bus. Remember, we have a destiny to reach. We have a place where we could be together. So all the primary 12, 144, and all the cell leaders, we need to be one on this. While we are in the middle of crisis, we are still in the vision, doing it, advancing God's kingdom. So making your vision and purpose come alive is the big issue right now. Either people are already dead or immovable or right now paralyzed or immobilized in the mission. So my goal this morning is to help you to make your vision and your purpose come alive again. So what is the steps, okay, so that we could make our vision come alive again? Write it down right now. I hope you have notes. Number one, by the way, I'd like to thank Pastor or Dr. Alvin Benson. I should share my notes, but I said no need, because I suddenly gave a job to Doc Alvin. He was a good note taker. So Pastor Alvin, you are gifted to do that. Okay, so thank you for helping me. I will tell you something. Sometimes when I teach here, I got my notes, and then suddenly the Holy Spirit intervened. I lost my notes. And then suddenly the Holy Spirit is just giving me an idea. And I was laughing at myself, because, oh my God, I lost my way, but the Holy Spirit come and intervene. Most of the teaching I gave you, most of them are given by the Holy Spirit. And I thank God for Doc Alvin, who constantly helping us, no, to take note. Now, let's go back to our topic. Take note number one. In the middle of crisis, you can only come alive if you stay positive together as a team. The moment you don't stay positive with your team, it dies down. It slows down everything. Okay? Stay positive. Okay? Alam nyo, we usually start positive and passionate in our vision. But as time goes on and challenges or crises emerge, sometimes we lose our positive attitude and strength for the vision. Yun po ang totoo. Sometimes we are good in beginnings, but we end up losing. Don't do that. Okay? Some of you are started with great passion and energy doing the vision. Okay? And then now, we are facing challenges. This crisis emerged in the middle of our excitement. Then suddenly, we slow down. And sometimes we lost the vision because of that. Okay? Every pastor should be a great pastor, not only in the beginnings. But you must be a great pastor throughout the journey. Okay? We need to stay positive together as a team. Through all these adversities, challenges, even setbacks and issues, and even in the middle of crisis, we need to be positive together. Let's get through it all. Okay? Every one of you. You and your leaders, you go through these things. But with positive mentality and outlook, okay? There was a saying, a team that stays together, succeed together. Okay? Brother and sister, we should never, because we usually focus on what's going wrong and we don't see what's going right. Positive means you're no longer looking at the what's going wrong. Because what is important is to see what's going right. Okay? The key to make your vision alive and a reality to you is to just stay positive. Do not focus on what's going wrong. Focus on what's going right. Because when you see what's going right, you see the opportunity. When you see what's going wrong, you will be discouraged. You will be frustrated. So instead of focusing on what's going wrong, now I focus on what's going right. Okay? Most pastors and leaders, they don't have positive attitude. And as a result, they sabotage themselves. Do you hear that? Once you carry a negative spirit, a wrong perspective, you have just sabotaged yourself. You sabotage your potential. You sabotage God's plan. You sabotage your gift. Because the only thing you see is negative. What's going wrong? But if you are positive, your potential come alive. Okay? Your energy come alive. your planning and strategic mind comes alive. Remember, never sabotage yourself by having wrong mindset. Okay? The pastor and his leaders that constantly live passively, one day at a time, you will notice that you will end up accomplishing a lot of things. So today, that's the first thing that we need to do. Okay? Every one of us must stay positive together as a team. Number two, okay? Believe together as a team. Yan ang pampabuhay, you know? Believe together. Hindi, not just stay positive, but stay together. Believe together as a team. Can you believe that we could be a great person? Let's just believe together. If Bishop Oriel is believing that I could become a great person out of this situation, do you know that right now I feel great? Because I don't feel I'm useless, you know? I'm trying to help. Whatever I could, I'm trying to help. Please, share this. This is a very important topic. Pindutin nyo yung share, ha? Yung likes, pindutin nyo. Mag-comment kayo. Yung mga nakakabilis na nadidinig nyo, i-comment nyo. Because your friends can watch it. Okay? Now, let me continue. Can you still believe that in the middle of crisis, kaya mo bang sabihin, I could be a legend? I could be a great person. Matindi, ganyan eh. We need to have that attitude. Believe that we could be great. Now, I think you have to bring your team together to become a great people. Sama mo naman yung primary 12 mo. Sama mo yung mga cell leader mo. Believe together as a team. Hey, in the middle of a crisis, do you know? I was meeting one of my 12 and I told him, do you know that majority of the churches now are in trouble? But you know, have you seen this? God has created something in our midst. Our church, Doulos for Christ, is a great church. Because it was led by great leaders like you. Brother and sister, let's believe together as a team that we are great leaders able to respond not to the wrong things that are happening, but seeing good things that are happening and making this as our opportunity so that we could become effective leaders. Okay? Pastor, I want you to hear this. Your number one priority is to inspire your team to believe. I will repeat that. I believe that the number one priority of the pastor during this crisis is to inspire your team, all your cell leaders, all your primary 12. Your responsibility is to inspire them to believe. They could be a great leaders during this pandemic problem. You know what? The truth is this. The pastor belief or faith must be transferred to our team, to our team of 12. And most importantly, to all cell leaders. And this cell leader will transfer this faith, this belief to each other and to every cell members they lead. So don't just stay positive. You need to believe as a team. Tell your team, this is the word. Write it down right now. So Doulos for Christ family, in the middle of this crisis, I want to tell you, inspire you. Let's be legendary. Hallelujah. Let's be a legend. Let's be great in the middle of this crisis. Sulat niyo yan. Lagay niyo sa refrigerator, sa bahay ninyo. Let's be legendary. We have to believe that we are a legend. We are here as leaders, citizens of the kingdom, helping these people find their way back to God. So let us all be legendary. Ang ganda po ng salita na yun. I want you to take it from your heart and say it and talk to yourself, I am legendary. Let's be legendary and let's be great. Naniniwala po ako, the greatest team don't just have great pastors, okay? Great primary team. Because they have great leaders within the team who inspire their team to believe in each other. Yan po ang kailangan natin. If you want your church to come alive, if you want your leadership to come alive, let's believe one another. Let's believe that we could be great people. Let's believe that we could become legendary in the middle of this crisis. And you know, it is powerful when you believe in your leaders. I believe in my leaders. To be a great team, I believe, it's even more powerful to believe in each other. Don't just believe on your leaders, let's believe on each others. Okay? If you want to accomplish great things together, you must believe together. Hallelujah. Stay positive, believe together. Number three, encourage each other. If you want your vision to come alive, people are discouraged, people are frustrated, they have physical problems like financial difficulties, economic problem. There will be health issues, you know, there will be bills issues, cash problem. And these people cannot make it without encouragement. Let us not forget, no one creates success alone. You need a team. Okay? You need each other. In the middle of this crisis, I really encourage everybody to encourage one another. We all need positive team to push and encourage you, as we all need encouragement from our own team. Pastors and primary 12, including all the leaders, I call you team. So when I say team, I'm talking about the primary 12, the 144, and your leaders. Your team. Make sure that you encourage one another. Okay? You cheer up one another. You support each other. Because when you encourage each other, you make one another stronger and stronger. I believe motivation is needed. Encouragement is needed. You know, inspiration is needed. Instruction is needed. If you keep on doing that, you're helping your team to come alive again. Let me tell you, just one encouragement, you just raise up the dead. I believe, once I visit a pastor, you just don't know. Sometimes I just visit a pastor through FaceTime, and they were so glad. They even post that I called them. Because I know, if I visit them, they will come alive. Because I will bring encouragement. I will bring motivations. And sometimes I visit different location in this world through FaceTime. You know, because my purpose is that I could motivate and encourage all these pastors and leaders. Because I want them to come alive. You know why I want them to come alive? Because my governor, the Holy Spirit, want me to go to do that. To make these people come alive. To make this vision come alive. And it will only come alive through encouragement. We have number four. Okay? Feed the positive dog. Feed the positive dog. Your mind is negative and positive. Your people, when you talk to them, they receive a lot of negative. It's just like the story. Do you still remember the wolf? When they're about to fight and they cheat the people. It was in Russian game. So what they did is this. They intentionally not to feed. Okay? So that that wolf will become weak. While the other dog was, you know, complete vitamins, complete and great food to make them strong. And then at the fight, you know, the one who received enough food, the other one have no food at all. He defeated. So that illustration, someone, a pastor, used that, like feeding the dog the negative and the positive. I want to use that we need to feed the positive dog. You come to your leaders, they receive a lot of negative news. They receive a lot of discouraging word. If they were not fed positive, they keep on eating the negative thoughts. They will become weak. They will be discouraged. They will be immobilized and paralyzed. And they cannot cope up with this crisis. So I encourage you, Pastor, this is your responsibility. Feed the positive dog. Complete dosage. Feeding of positive, encouraging, motivational thoughts to your leaders. Number five, talk to yourself and not to listen to yourself. What do I mean by that? If you want your people to come alive, feed positive thing, right? But the key here is the pastor, the leaders. Leaders and pastors must learn how to talk to yourself and not to listen to yourself. There was a man with the name of James Hill. Triathlon athlete po ito eh, no? He completed the double triathlon. In two triathlon, back-to-back with only 24 hours rest or break, no? Do you know that this man, James Gills, Dr. James Gills, sixth time and the last time he had it, he was 59 years old. 59 years old, nanalo pa ng triathlon. He was so strong. And then, he was asked by the media, how did you do that? You are 59 years old. You still win this triathlon six times. You only have 24 hours of break and rest. But you won this championship triathlon. His answer is very definite and very encouraging. He said, I have learned to talk to myself instead of listening to myself. What do he mean by that? He said that I memorize scripture and I would recite it to myself. Because if I listen to myself, he said, myself is talking to me. And if I listen to myself, he said, I hear all the reason why I should give up. Imagine mo, yourself is talking to you. Give up. And I hear myself that I am too tired now. I have to give up. I am now too old. I have to give up. Myself is keep on talking to me that you are too weak now to make it. Stop running. Give up. That's why he said, I don't listen to myself. I talk to myself. When I talk to myself, I can give myself an encouragement. I can give myself words that I need to hear to keep running and finish the race. If we want our vision come alive, don't listen to yourself. Don't listen to other people. Talk to yourself. We can make it. Encourage yourself. Talk to yourself by encouraging yourself. Those words that you need to hear will never come from anyone. Talk to yourself. Ako, kinakausap ko sarili ko eh. Kaya mo yan. Ha? We keep on doing the vision, Oriel. Kaya natin to. Ha? But myself is talking to me. Oriel, mahirap ngayon. Crisis. Tsaka, ganito, ganyan, mahirapan ka. Ang mga tao, malalayo. So if I listen to myself, hindi ko na ito gagawin. But I decided not to listen to myself. I decided to talk to myself. I said, Oriel, keep on doing the vision. There are thousands of pastors waiting for you, and you have to do it. Excited po ako. Nawala yung mga kung ano-anong iniisip ko. So I never listen to myself. I talk to myself. Mga kapatid, that's how to make your vision alive. Because if you listen to yourself, you will give up. You will give up. I never listen to myself. I talk to myself. I read the scripture. I listen to the governor. And then I begin to talk to myself. Every words that I say to myself comes from the Word of God. Comes from the Holy Spirit. And every time I talk to myself, I feel so encouraged. I feel so motivated. I was inspired, okay? I talk to myself. And then I talk to myself, what is our strategy, Oriel? What is our plan? I begin to talk to myself. And the vision come alive. I promise you, don't listen to yourself. Because yourself will tell you, you have to give up. You have to stop. You have to, you know, you are in the middle of crying. They will stop you. If you talk to yourself, if you listen to yourself, I should say, never, ever listen to yourself. Talk to yourself. Number six, okay? Replace the word I had to with I get to. Okay? Alam niyo po, for many pastor and for many ministry, we look at the ministry as an obligation. Some of you are doing live streaming because you feel you are obligated, huh? Some of you, you are meeting your people because you feel obligated. You have to do it. You have to do it. I have to do it. Well, when the spirit of entitlement gets in, we begin to stop appreciating the opportunity and the journey. Listen very carefully. Hallelujah. Listen very carefully. When you feel entitled, okay, we will stop appreciating the opportunity and the great journey that God has given us. We're not doing this because we have to. No. We get to do this. We get to do this. Hallelujah. We should never stop appreciating the opportunity we have to do the work we do and the people we do it with. Ang sarap pong maglingkod sa Panginoon. Hindi ako napipilitan. Ginagawa ko to. Hallelujah. Right now, with a simple shift of your words, do you know that there is power in your words? I believe what you have to do is different from what you get to do. You get the opportunity to live this life. You get the opportunity. You get to work with the things that is making difference. You get to learn and grow each day. You get to do it. Not you have to do it. You get to work well so that many others, okay, can receive your ministry. Hallelujah. You've got to wake up. Why? Because while so many other people is dying, can never wake up anymore. You get to wake up. When you replace I have to attitude with I get to attitude, you stop complaining, you change your complaining voice to an appreciative heart. Yan po ang kailangan natin. We need to have an appreciative heart. And when you appreciate, you elevate yourself and your team to the next level. Remember, life and work is a gift, not an obligation. Remember that. Stop being entitled. Start appreciating all the opportunities you and your team have been given. Meron talaga. Ang gaganda po. Number 7, make the next opportunity great. Okay? Make the next opportunity great. We have to take note on our perspective, how we see the world now that we are in crisis. Okay? If you want to become a useless person, ito po sabi nila, you become a pastor. Imagine, this is the thought of the world. Imagine they told me, if you want to become a useless pastor, a person, you need to become a pastor. What? You mean, because they perceive, the world perceive, that we as pastor are useless. Hallelujah. They think that a pastor is living a useless life. Well, I'd like to say this, I don't believe pastor's life is useless. Okay? Probably they see a lot of pastor living a life of failure. Well, for me, it's different. We can fail, of course. We can fail. In fact, everybody fail. Everybody experience it. I believe a pastor should live a life of opportunity. And no matter what happened to his life and his family, as a pastor, I will always get that opportunity to make my life great again. Some of you, the vision has died already, or probably it was immobilized and paralyzed because you failed. Because you failed. I want you to understand that get ready. Get ready. Because God is about to give you great opportunity. Make the next opportunity great. if you can able to recover right now, you've just got the opportunity. Now, let's get that opportunity great in our life. Number 8, I'm lost. Okay? The team, the pastor, we must be lost. What is L-O-S-S? It means learning opportunity and stay strong. You need to stay strong. If you want your vision can come alive, okay? Learning opportunity and stay strong is the key, okay? We had to learn to see our challenges not as challenges but as opportunity. Problem, opportunity. Parang, you know, touch the Japanese and these Chinese people. They don't have the word crisis in their vocabulary. The only word that they have is crisis, is opportunity. Opportunity. So when a Japanese or a Chinese have a problem and he was to ask for counsel, like to his boss, he said, "Sir, I have an opportunity now." They never say, "I have a problem." I have an opportunity. You see that? Why do I say that? Because we need to learn opportunity and stay strong. Learning opportunity, stay strong during crisis makes your team, make your church come alive. Okay? This is our learning opportunity. That's why we stay strong. Brother and sister, I know there's a challenge. I know there is a problem, but challenge can turn to opportunity. Problem can make opportunity. That's why, literally, it means learning opportunity and stay strong. Hallelujah. In the midst of our struggle, we can look for and found opportunity. Always, you can always see that. And you must remember that crisis is going to happen to your job, to your family, to our city and nation. But it's not to put us and get stuck us in the mud forever. No. Just keep your head up, okay? Look for the opportunity, and the good thing is coming. It's coming your way even in the middle of crisis, okay? So you begin to ask the question, how can we learn from this? How can we grow from this? What do you want to do now? What action will be taken? That should be your question right now, as we go through challenges in life. Hallelujah. And as a team, we have to stay strong. Huh? Lagi tayo malakas, dapat lagi natin together. Because if you are strong, you can turn the challenges, the problem, the crisis into an even greater opportunities and great result. So my brother and sister, instead of complaining and whining for the loss that happened during the crisis, we need to come together. And we begin to ask ourselves, what opportunity do we have as we serve God? What opportunity do we have during this crisis? What should I do to these people? What should I do with my family, with my cell leaders? You need to ask those questions because those are your opportunity. Okay? And we need to be intentional and we need an immediate action. Quick. We need to shift immediately our focus and attention. Kasi, you know, at this moment, you must be so quick to shift your focus. You know, you have to shift quickly your attention so that you could minister effectively to people, so that we could grow greater. No? There will be greater success and growth in our ministry. Shift nyo na kaagad. Don't stay too long to those wrong things that are happening. Suddenly shift it to those right things that are happening. Number 9. Ito, maganda po ito. This is powerful. Live like a shark, not a goldfish. You know what is the difference between goldfish and shark? Goldfish always wait for somebody to feed him. That's the goldfish mentality. What about shark? Shark is looking for opportunity to feed himself. That's the idea. Live like a shark. Find your opportunity. Look for your opportunity. Discover your opportunity. Do not be like a goldfish. Dami pong pastor parang goldfish. Nag-aanap lang ng opportunity. O naghihintay lang ng relief, naghihintay lang ng pera. No, you have your opportunity. Live like a shark. Tell your children, your leaders, live like a shark. We will look for opportunity. Huh? We will not like goldfish or waiting for somebody to feed us. I promise you, the wave of crisis has come your way. And when this crisis hits you, you have a choice. You can resist change or you can ride the wave of crisis to a successful future. That's the idea. Instead of being a goldfish, no? And waiting to be fed like in a good old days, no? We need to embrace this change. It's time to embrace the change and look for our opportunities. To find more food like a shark. To find more opportunity. To find our greatness in the middle of this situation. You know? To find things that we could be great. You know? To find things that we could use our gift. Shark mentality. Not goldfish mentality. The key factor for our success will be our perspective. How we see the change we are experiencing right now. Those who saw it as bad things and resisted it, it will be crushed in the middle of that crisis. But those who saw it as a good thing and an opportunity, they ride the wave of crisis to a better future. Pinakauli sa lahat, number 10, think like a rookie. Think like a rookie. Why should I say think like a rookie? If you want your vision come alive, you can never afford to think like a senior citizen. You behave like a rookie. What I mean when I said to think like a rookie, you need to stop looking for the good old days we complain about. Huh? The way things are and we are unwilling to change and some things you allowed our past experience, good or bad, to affect our present future. Alam niyo po, the past is past. Your good old days is over. If you keep on going back to your old past, you behave like a veteran. I know this. These are the good old days. You are missing that. You see those pastors right now? They've been telling you, alam mo, namimiss ko na yung church building natin. Those are good old days. Huh? Alam mo, namimiss ko na yung ating, ano, yung ating facilities, na meron tayong worship. But when you are young rookie, when I'm a rookie pastor, I don't even have a building. Do you understand that? I don't even have a people to work with me. I'm a rookie. With no Bible school background, I'm a rookie. But guess what? I grow my church to more than 20,000 people because I never lose my rookie spirit. I always create new things. I always adjust myself, recreate myself to whatever environment I went into, to whatever condition that I am going through. Yung iba kasi sa inyo, naging utak veterans na eh. You cannot afford to have a veteran mindset now. Go back to your rookie attitude. Hallelujah. Why? Because all rookie are winning the award now. Nowadays, they are the ones. You look at when Pajardo here in the Philippines NBA, he keep on winning rookie MVP. When Kobe Bryant rookie became an MVP immediately. Shaquille O'Neal, Jordan, those rookies suddenly become, you know, they are getting the award. Hallelujah. I believe our old experience will be shaken by the crisis. Huh? And when you are shaken by the crisis, all your old mindset, all your mentality, you will be transformed to a shark. From a shark to become what? Now you become a goldfish. I'm happy to see pastors living like a shark. They are always watching, observing, looking for an opportunity for a big meal. While the goldfish, di niya ba napansin, they look like veteran pastor. They are just waiting to be fed. They're just waiting. And as a result, okay, they allowed the crisis to paralyze them. They begin to be, I should say, defined by their circumstances. Because they were constantly complaining about the crisis. They keep on complaining about the economy. Why not create a new economy? That's the idea. Okay? We have cursed our experience here in crisis. I want to tell you that the antidote was to think like a rookie again. Ito pong nangyayari sa atin ngayon. I encourage every pastor, do not behave like a veteran. That you are always looking for the old ways of doing things. You think like a rookie, as if this is your first time to do your ministry, and you are willing to do everything you can because you are just starting. Rookie pastors. That's what we need. Rookie cell leaders, rookie primary 12. When you begin to think like a rookie, you forget all the old things that you are doing in the past. You are now ready to do something different. You are challenging the veterans now. You believe that I could be better than these old players. You know, that's my heart for today. Because I know I cannot come alive if I stay with the spirit of a veterans, the good old days. We could come alive, my brother and sister. We could come. Oh, daming goldfish dyan, ha? Yung mga goldfish dyan. Patayin nyo na lahat yung goldfish. Hanggang sa material na lang mga shark. I believe goldfish mentality will destroy your ministry. I believe the shark must be back in your heart. I'm a rookie. I want to operate like a new pastors who knows nothing but willing to listen to the Holy Spirit to be guided. And I promise you, you will succeed. Brother and sister, in this pandemic condition, we need our vision to come alive. Be sure you and your team come alive out of this desperate condition. So today, my brother and sister, thank you so much. I pray and I hope that all these things happen for a purpose. In Jesus' name, let your vision come alive. I will pray. Let's pray. Father, I thank you because I believe, Lord, that we could come alive. The vision can come alive because the kingdom culture and the kingdom influence is changing us, Lord. Yes, Lord, we should never see what's wrong, but we should see what's going good, Lord. Today, we submit to you, Lord God, our wrong mindset and mentality. But today, God, I pray that as we hear your word, vision will come alive again, Lord. Visions will become another movement again, Lord. Vision will be activated again, Lord. And I believe we will conquer again, Lord. We could set goals, we could plan and strategize again. And the vision is back and come alive. With all my our leaders, the primary 12 and our cell leaders. So thank you. Bless every pastors, bless every leaders who come alive, Lord, out of this broadcasting ministry, Lord. Thank you. May you be glorified in Jesus' name. Amen, amen.